What's up, hungry ones? Welcome to Quarter Munchers. I am Johnny.
And I am young Mitch.
Oh shit, oh shit, oh
Carefully
shit,
now,
oh shit,
carefully
oh shit,
now.
oh shit, oh shit. Dude, just looking at this gives me like the worst fucking anxiety.
Don't worry, if you fall, you'll only lose half a heart, but it'll be horrifying. All right, now get sneaky, get swifty, get your sneak on. Now you see those fucking fireflies? Get up nice and close.
To my surprise.
Get him, get him. Yeah. Yeah, fucking Captain Mal over here.
It's not a girl's
Goddamn
name.
Cutie.
Oh, hi.
Oh, yeah, a couple of boyos. A couple of Boko boys. Boko boys.
I've still actually yet to sneak kill somebody. Let's try this.
It's... Again, it's a really straightforward system. Oh, you actually do have to be in, like, behind them. Huh. But his back is to the ground. He cannot be snuck up on. Oh, wait, never mind. What the fuck? Got a fang. Yeah, get him. Whack.
Yes.
Pick up a new one.
Got the spear.
Got the old.
I can't carry anymore.
That's okay. The Boko Club's pretty good.
Yeah.
For now.
I feel like a spear isn't going to be worth it. Wait, did I? Is that it? That's a... Oh, it's a cabin.
It's a cliff. Oh, yeah.
That's back across the chasm. I'm going to fuck with that later.
Yeah. We got ourselves a nice little one, you know, one of the few things they kept, the obviously cracked wall for bombing.
Oh, yeah. I was just going to use this climbing, but
whoops.
Now that you mention it. Hello. Ooh, that's a very ornate chest.
Yeah, real pretty.
Fire arrow.
Surprisingly, yeah, fire arrows. No more fucking shoot an arrow into the sun on Lake Hylia at goddamn sunrise, and none of that bullshit. They're just around now.
Oh, that's not the sneak button. Fuck.
Oh yeah, you have to click the left nipple.
Then oh god.
You can. I don't think from this side. Maybe.
I feel like I did
climb up this. Not this side of this cliff, but you can climb up this cliff. Cliff Lazinski.
Cliff Burton.
Cliffy B. Yeah. Oh man. Cliff's chin.
Cliffs of Dover.
Oh, Jesus, God. That fucking song.
Yeah.
There we go. That looks doable. It's got some nice stoppy spots, some sweet, tasty mushrooms. Oh, with the dangerous jumping.
I thought that was that at the top of that was a little resting point. Evidently, it's not sloped enough to be a resting point.
Oh, yeah. That is one nice thing they do in the game is if you can stand on a spot instead of climbing, usually Link will, like, automatically switch to standing.
Yeah.
Even if it's not, like, obviously, like, a place, you know, if it's not an obvious ledge, it might just be, like, you know, a place where the slope gets a little flatter. And it might be just enough.
Shake out those arms.
You can find those little spots, yeah.
Shake out those arms. Stop fighting your battle with lactic acid.
It's a never-ending struggle.
Yeah, that is one of my favorite things about when America was first treated to the joys of Ninja Warrior on G4.
Oh,
they had
yeah.
the subtitles for the commentator.
Oh man, that reminds me. But go ahead first.
But there was one. I think it was Nagano-san was going up, going through stage 3. And like he starts hanging off of a sudden. He's like, he now begins his battle with lactic acid was the translation.
Nice. It's probably pretty much what he said, I imagine. But speaking of Ninja Warrior, have you seen or heard of Ultimate Beastmaster?
It is on my watch list on Netflix, and I have to.
Watch the at least the first episode. Like, I think you will continue to watch it if you watch the first one, but dude, it's got Terry Crews. It's got bonus points. It's got Koreans. It's got everything.
Does it have Pumko?
It might, you know. Someday it might, as like a fucking commentator.
These items are called rushrooms.
Yeah, they the species didn't appear until God damn it. What's the name of the album that's like a year? Is it 2120?
2112.
Oh, 20. That's right. I was thinking like, you know, the much better Ninja Sex Party version, 6969. I was like, is it 2121 or?
As a Rush fan, bro, that fucking hurts.
I gotta say, I'm not a huge Rush guy.
It is not for everyone. I will say that much.
Seriously though, like, fucking 6969 is pretty great.
It is fucking great, and I love the fact that the dude from Steel Panther is in there.
Yeah.
Shoot the fucking lasers! Way more fucking lasers at him.
Oh man, another shrine. Yo, a dame shrine.
I was hoping he was gonna be in the video for that, but he probably schedule concerns.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard enough getting somebody just to do a recording session.
Yeah.
And having to shoot a video, too.
I mean, like, the whole band was in the video for Road Trip.
Yeah, that's true. But, I mean, really, they only show up... Well, I guess... No, fuck. Because both videos are shot pretty much entirely in front of green screen.
Yeah. Oh, a damn!
Yeah. Oh, a damn! That fucking
stasis trial. Yeah. Let's download the new app.
But yeah, Ultimate Beastmaster is great. It's so good. I love a lot of the things they did, like in terms of gamification. So in Ninja Warrior, you either finish the stage and you move on to the next one, or you fail and you don't move on.
Yeah, like that's that the it's pass fail.
Yeah. And as a result, in like Ninja Warrior, like it was really rare. Like in some respects, it was a good system because, you know, it meant that whenever anyone actually made it to the last stage, it was a big fucking deal. Excuse me.
Yeah.
But there, you know, there were like whole seasons of that show where, you know, you'd get like three guys who make it to stage three and like all fuck up or something, you know. It could potentially be not as exciting because there's just like no competition at a certain stage.
Yeah.
Or, you know, it's just too hard or not hard enough or whatever. With Ultimate Beastmaster, it's points based instead of pass fail. So
yeah, that alone sounds like something. It's not that I don't like Ninja Warrior. I fucking love that show.
Oh yeah.
But I agree that, like, the fact that it is pass-fail makes it really, really just not appealing. Like, you could get seasons where, like, not everyone makes it past stage one. Like, I remember after Nagano-san won it, they redesigned the whole chorus and said, we want to make a stage one that nobody gets past.
Yeah. And nobody did. So we got that stasis, brah. Bzow!
How long do I have before it stops?
Like 5 seconds.
Okay,
six,
so it's generous.
There. Yeah, it's plenty of time for like any of the puzzles you have to do. But yeah,
fuck me.
Oh, perfect.
Oh,
you lose.
I will say that the deaths in this game, like, they really, like, punish. Like, it makes you feel like you just fucked up. Like,
killed a poor innocent child.
Oh, like, I felt that boulder head. I was like, ah!
He just crumpled. That was brutal, man.
Yeah, like, that is... that. Please tell me I don't have to go back and get the rune.
He feels it all. Let's find out.
No, you don't.
You don't have to go through the little cutscene again.
Stop.
But yeah, so with Ultimate Beastmaster, what they do is... each obstacle in a stage is worth a certain number of points. So even if you don't finish a stage, if you do well, if you beat as well as, you know, the rest of the competition or better, you still advance. And there's, like, bonus point objectives you can go for in a stage. Oh, okay, you got it in time.
Yeah, I didn't think I did either.
It's like, oh, he might get stuck. There might be hitboxes. Fuck, what was I gonna...
Points for a stage.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's points and there's these bonus point things you can get. Oh, yeah, a hidden extra chest.
Do that so I can actually get up here in time. How's it going, guys? I like what you have.
I was really hoping, like, stopping that boulder wouldn't have stopped the boulders from dropping. And
you sick bitch.
Because I just ran through. I didn't even think to stop it. And now you have a shield.
Fuck. Okay.
Ah, you're fine. It's the beginning of the game. This is still the tutorial zone.
Oh, hi. Ooh,
Iron Sledgehammer.
Okay, let's fix something here real quick.
Ian probably dropped one of those Korok leaves. They're not really weapons, they're utilities. You just make wind with it. So you really only need one. And even then, they fall off trees. They literally grow on trees! So you don't really need it most of the time.
Yeah, okay, you do this, and then it's... how do you throw?
Oh, it's, not the bow button. Oh, wait, no, I think it won't let you throw that because it's a Korok leaf, maybe.
Oh.
You can just go into the menu and drop it.
Making me have to do the actual, like, jerks.
Yeah.
Me do stuff. Where is it?
In this beautiful, perfect, almost perfect video game.
Drop. Okay.
But,
How terrible is that swing? Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, it's really the recovery that's bad. The recovery on that thing is super bad. Oh, gee. What can we do here? In this trial that's designed to teach us... there we go! Oh, whack it. Whack it! Give it a good whack! Keep whacking it! Oh, hey!
Oh, wow. That's fucking cool!
Yeah. Yeah, you can, like... it's like fucking Dio's Time Stop. You can build up momentum and, like, fucking throw 99s at Jotaro, and his stand comes out and, like, catches most of them, but, like, one of them still hits him, and he's all... ugh.
I love you so much for the JoJo reference.
Your resourcefulness in overcoming, in the name of Goddess Hylia, I bestow you upon the spirit or...
Hylia.
Oh, fuck, dude. That reminds me. Takashi Miike is apparently directing a live-action adaptation of Part 4 of JoJo's.
Really?
Yeah, there's already a teaser out.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
May the goddess smile upon you.
The man who gave us Audition and Ichi the Killer and Yakuza Apocalypse and Gozu and Detective Story and Happiness of the Katakuris is giving us JoJo's.
I legit for a second was going to accuse you of just looking at a fucking IMDb page, but...
oh, no, I've seen him. I am quite a fan.
So that's 3 out of the 4 markers down.
And 13 assassins. And the live action adaptation of Ryuga Gotoku, or Yakuza, and Ace Attorney.
Right.
He has done quite a variety of work. Oh no, it's too cold. It's too cold for you, you little linky boy.
What? I'm in the sun. It's pretty.
pretty cold.
Oh, it's probably elevation based.
Kind of, yeah. And like, what's the word? Biome, climate, biome's about right. Oh, butterfly.
All right.
Little spoiler, this is basically the part of the game, because the last shrine that you need is up in this snowy area. So you are literally in the area of the game that's supposed to teach you about cooking, so that you can
okay, gotcha.
Make something to deal with the cold. It's actually back in the direction you came from. Not ahead of you, unfortunately.
Oh, it's down by like the where you first encounter the cold. Okay. So I have to descale the mountain.
Yeah, unfortunately. And then once you do that, you can fry it up in a nonstick pan, little butter, salt, pepper, maybe some lemon juice, and you'll have yourself a tasty steak.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say, please, heavens, tell me I don't need to go. Ooh, wait, hold on.
Oh, dame. Oh, what's this? A big rock. Yeah, whack it. Whack it real good. Keep whacking it.
Pew! Okay, that is really satisfying.
It's great.
Oh, another bow just in case the other one breaks. Not bad.
Yeah, which the bows do break, but not as fast as, like, the swords.
I am not.
This is, yeah, maybe not where you want to climb down. probably not.
No, it's not, because that's the side that was originally going to come up.
Yeah, and I think you were further back, so you weren't even over, like, the little strip of land.
Yeah, so I want to, yeah. It's over here, isn't it? Yeah, there it is.
Yeah.
Doot, doot, do.
And, I mean, Link is pretty tolerant to falling.
Fuck no! Like,
I didn't mean that tolerant.
Here's the justification for that death.
Oh, were you holding? I know exactly what you did. You were holding down on the stick and you hit X to jump, thinking Link will jump down so that you can get down the mountain faster. And instead he jumped away from it.
That is precisely what just happened.
I had the same idea in, I think, exactly the same spot of the game. Because, like, every other jump keeps you stuck to the side of the mountain.
Oh.
And, okay, so you, I think you still have your bow, because it looks like the chest disappeared.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Oh, that's... It's like this game punishes you for trying to take a shortcut in any fashion.
Yeah. I mean, I think it's one of those things where, you know, like, they would have implemented a down jump. But they also wanted, like, that, it's like a Shadow of the Colossus thing where you have to jump from, you know, away from one wall and towards another.
Yeah.
So I think that's why, you know, it's just one where they had to pick, like, one thing or the other. And they picked the inconsistent one, but it makes Link more mobile as a result, so.
Yeah, the positives do outweigh the negatives, certainly.
Yeah. Plus, when you get the paraglider, you can jump off the side of a cliff, and since you're jumping away from it, you pop out the glider, and yeah, it works nicely.
Do, climbing down the side of a mountain.
Yeah.
Cow and chicken, yeah! Cow and chicken, yeah!
Oh man, I haven't thought about that cartoon in a while.
I was gonna say, was that cartoon a little bit before your time, or was that that was?
No, that was right in my wheelhouse.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
That and like Dexter's Lab, Johnny Bravo, all those.
Oh, Johnny fucking Bravo!
Ah, oh, God, I really like I have fondish memories of like Dexter's Lab and Cow and Chicken and a lot of the like Powerpuff Girls too and whatnot. But man, I miss the shit out of Johnny Bravo.
Oh, dude, totally.
Like, that's the one I really wish. I wish, I guess maybe not that they would bring it back, but I'd love to watch it again at some point. Bonk.
That didn't happen. There it is.
Yeah. See, that's like one of the other things with the weapon system is like there's, you know, weapons that are clearly for utility. Like the axe, the hammer, the Korok leaf, but they still take up spots in your inventory in like your weapon list. And I wish there was an item box so I could just have like, you know, just have an axe and a hammer and a leaf stored for like if I maybe need them.
Sorry.
Oh God, that was close.
Sorry.
There you go. We're back on safe dry land now.
Call me old man.
Old man. Oh, fancy that. So we meet again. Horadrim. I thought this tree here might make some good firewood, despite the fact that it is green and young and healthy. I don't know anything about forestry. What year? However, getting a tree to fall exactly where you want it to is quite an art. Especially not on your own fucking head. That's the real trick. The trick is to turn your hips so that they face where you want the tree to land. Then you shake them. Shake them like Shakira. Yes, that's it. Keep shaking it. Now turn around. Let me see that tushy. So, I see you found my axe. Why'd you steal it?
By the way, you've requested tushy, so here you go.
Why not help me out and give it a few swings? That's right, swing that axe around. Show me that axe.
Okay, I'm good. I'm mature, I promise.
It's a nice, tight, firm axe.
But these bones could use a break.
Hey, I'll show you.
Thank
bones
you, old man, for completing our joke.
All right, so let's check out that cabin we saw.
Cabin in the woods. That,
yeah. That sounded positively teenage. Oh, my fuck. Oh, there was a squirrel. I think you can catch squirrels.
You're walking in the woods. There's no one around you, and your phone is dead. Out of the corner of your eye, you see him.
Oh, Shyamalan. Oh, God, he's coming.
He's gaining on you about 30 paces back. He gets down on all fours and breaks into a sprint. He's gaining on you.
Oh, Shia LaBeouf.
Running from your life, it's Shia LaBeouf. Good old-fashioned internet.
He's brandishing a knife, Shia LaBeouf.
Good old-fashioned internet.
Eating all the bodies.
Actual cannibal Shia LaBeouf. By the way, I love that belch was on beat. That's perfect. So this is his cabin.
Let's have a look around in here. Ooh, a tasty baked apple. Let's have a more thorough look around in here. Couple of spicy peppers.
The old man's diary. Read.
Yes. Let's find out his dirty little secrets. On this desolate plateau, the only pleasure that brings me comfort is cooking.
I'll keep you my dirty little secret.
And today I outdid myself. This old man, he what if he wrote in all the old man sounds? Truly, I created the perfect dish. I call it spicy meat and seafood fry.
This is a testament to my maturity, is the fact that you just made fart noise with your mouth and I'm giggling like a fucking 13-year-old. And I'm the one getting married in a year.
Yay. Spicy meat indeed. Oh, what I wouldn't do to have a piece of spicy meat in me.
Anyway.
This recipe not only restores health, but it also keeps me warm, even when traveling in these mountains. Hey, wink, wink. Hot damn. How convenient. With this dish on my side, I no longer have need of that itchy, warm doublet.
Ooh, tell me more, tell me more.
Oh, man, that reminds me of the fucking the song from Grease.
That's... Yes, we were both on the same page.
I don't know the line.
I don't either. I just know it's like, tell me more, tell me more. Does he have a big dick?
And in my head, it's just, tell me more. Does she fuck like a whore?
Yes.
I don't know how I allowed this to happen, but it seems I forgot down to write down a very important recipe. The secret to a good lumpkin.
Oh,
only I could remember. I know it contained raw meat and spicy pepper. Some spice. God damn it. I just thought of the spicy meat fucking meme. I simply cannot remember what else I used. My age is catching up to me.
Do we dare read more?
Sure, why not? Sadly, on this lonely plateau, I have only my own knowledge and memory to rely on. Still, if I could find just one vintage Playboy around here somewhere, I'd be happy for months. If I did find someone who knew the missing ingredient, I would happily reward them with my warm doublet.
Eventually I'll probably stop laughing at that joke, but it's so good.
However, it seems unlikely that such a miraculous wish will ever be fulfilled.
Fuck you, I'm Link, bitch. We'll figure it out.
Yeah. Well, spicy pepper and hot meat.
It's about right. So, with that, we're actually going to end an episode where I don't die horribly.
Aw, oh, come on.
All right, where's the cliff?
You don't have to.
No, 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 no. The people want it.
Oh, good call.
The people will Mark. It. Oh, that's not a cliff. That's
where, just a
there
a
it
dip.
Is. There's the ravine I'm looking for. Fuck.
Oh, I thought we were playing Steep. We had the wingsuit.
At the time of recording this, by the way, that's free this weekend.
Oh, shit.
So, there's that. So, if you guys like what you see, leave us a comment down below. Let us know how you're doing and how we're doing. But we do want to know how you're doing. We love you guys. Especially you, Hard Hunt. Looking at you. Shout-outs. So, leave us a comment down below. Let us know how we're doing. Like, share, and subscribe to the channel, as always. Follow us on social media at Quarter Munchers and on Twitch at @Quarter_Munchers. Until then, I am Johnny.
I am the only Mitch.
And the arcade is closed. Oh, man. Tarzan Boy is the greatest song in the world.
That.